Octopus Books presents The Little Book of Sleep. The Art of Natural Sleep. Written and read by Dr Nerina Ramlakhan. Introduction. Sleep is that golden chain that ties health and our bodies together, wrote the Elizabethan dramatist Thomas Dekker. There's nothing better than a good night's sleep, is there? We wake up feeling refreshed, happy, and looking forward to the day ahead. The history of insomnia probably goes back to the time of our earliest ancestors. They lived in a world that was so unsafe that it might have been dangerous to retire to a cave and simply pass out for 7 or 8 hours on a mat of leaves. We might have become extinct if they'd slept like that. So there are times when we don't sleep because we need to be vigilant and to take care of the business of life. And we are well equipped to deal with poor sleep. Night after night of poor sleep, however, can take its toll. We're designed to spend a third of our lives sleeping, and we really do need our sleep. The pace of modern life is fast, and although technology is meant to make things easier for us, instead, we've ended up with more demands on our time and energy. Longer to-do lists, less downtime, and certainly less rest. Unsurprisingly, the use of sleeping pills has increased dramatically in recent years. More people are suffering from exhaustion, burnout, and mental health problems. According to the Institute of Medicine, an estimated 50 to 70 million US adults have issues with insomnia and wakefulness. Now, perhaps more than ever, we need our sleep to rebalance, repair, and replenish ourselves from the demands of the day. What does it mean to get a good night's sleep? It's not just about quantity. It's about getting the right type and quality of sleep. I use the Sanskrit word sattvic to describe the type of sleep we should be getting. Pure, deep, natural, and healing. This is the kind of sleep where you wake up feeling refreshed, filled with vitality, and looking forward to the day ahead. It not only heals us, but also heals those around us. We wake up smiling, and that energy is contagious. It affects our loved ones, the people we encounter on our journey into work, our colleagues, our clients, and the very work that we do, the work of life. When we sleep deeply, rejuvenation takes place on many levels: physical, emotional, mental, and spiritual. Let's explore these in more detail. Physical. We wake up with the energy and vitality we need to go about our day's tasks. The body is repaired and the immune system is strengthened. Emotional. We are able to engage fully in our relationships with courage and open-heartedness and deal with life's inevitable ups and downs. Mental. The brain is cleaned up and reorganized and we feel creative and focused, even in the face of overflowing inboxes and constant demands from technology. And last, but not least, spiritual. We can live with meaning, passion, and inspiration, finding time for those things that we truly care about. In short, sattvic sleep enables us to be the best that we can be, the best version of ourselves, and to live our lives with purpose and meaning. An innate ability. Dormancy is part of the cycle of life. In order to thrive, fields must lie fallow, animals must sleep or hibernate. Researchers have been studying the day and night cycle in plants for a long time. The 18th century Swedish naturalist Carl Linnaeus observed that flowers in a dark cellar continue to open and close. And in the 19th century, Charles Darwin recorded the overnight movement of plant leaves and stalks and called it sleep. More recently, scientists in Austria, Finland, and Hungary have used sophisticated infrared laser scanning techniques to take pictures of trees sleeping. Their results, documented on the Frontiers in Plant Science website, show that the whole tree droops during the night. And they measured position changes in leaves of up to 10 centimetres for trees with a height of about 5 metres. A natural process of oscillation is encoded in our DNA. This is well documented in a field of biology called chronobiology, which is the study of the effect of time, and in particular rhythms, on living systems. All of nature follows a natural rhythm of energy expenditure and rest. Sleep is an innate ability that follows an inbuilt rhythm that is in sync with nature. The periods of light and dark, the changing of the seasons, the waxing and waning of the moon, and the movement of tides. But today's hectic way of life and the constant flood of information bombarding our brain have dulled our connection with this natural ability. In order to get sattvic sleep, we need to reawaken this knowledge. If your sleep problems have been going on for a long time, you might feel that it's simply not possible for you to get this type of sleep. I want to reassure you that it is possible. You just need to know how to trigger it. Live deeply, sleep deeply. If all of nature sleeps, why is it so difficult for us? Why have we become so disconnected from ourselves? Electronic devices are amazing, easy to use, they're so seductive. But they can have such a negative impact on our health, sleep patterns, energy levels, and even on our relationships. The problem, however, lies not with technology, but the way that we're using it. We constantly live on the surface of life, and in the process, we have lost touch with what lies within us, the true source of our healing rhythms and bodily wisdom. To sleep deeply, we need to live deeply. This means that we need to reconnect with ourselves and our inner stillness. It's not surprising that in the Western world, practices such as yoga and mindfulness have become popular as more people seek inner peace and grounding to counterbalance the frenetic pace of life. Recent scientific studies have shown that spending time in nature can improve our sleep drastically by reconnecting us with our innate sleep rhythms. For example, Kenneth Wright, a researcher at the University of Colorado, Boulder, conducted a study in 2013 called The Entrainment of the Human Circadian Clock to the Natural Light-Dark Cycle. For this study, he sent people on a week-long summer camping trip to understand how their internal clocks changed without electronics and only natural light. Before and after the trip, he measured their levels of the sleep hormone melatonin. Wright found that people's internal body clocks were delayed by 2 hours in their modern environment, but they were able to recalibrate after a week in nature. I'm passionate about helping people to sleep. I have had problems sleeping myself. When I was 6 months old, in desperation, my mother took me from one doctor to the next to find help. I was such a restless baby. This restlessness continued into my 30s and I became very ill. At this point, I already had a doctorate in neurophysiology, but becoming ill set me on a personal mission to learn even more about sleep. I started going into large companies to give presentations on sleep. For more than a decade, I worked in a psychiatric clinic where people with severe mental health problems needed deep, healing sleep. I also worked with premiership.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.